Welcome back, dear viewers. Thanks so much for staying with us. You're watching Niall Cruz here on Niall TV International. And now it's time for another topic of discussion in today's episode. And we're going to be talking about the Global Youth Ambassadors team in Egypt. They are representing Egypt's voice worldwide on global movements to solve crises like education and other crises facing our world. They help in community development and empowering leaders and entrepreneurs for a better future. Their hope is to unite all youth power organizations under one stewardship and to represent them internationally. And we're most delighted to be joined here on location with a member of the Global Youth Ambassadors team, and he's Mustafa Ibrahim. Mustafa, good afternoon, and thank you so much for joining us on Niall Cruz.
Good afternoon, thank you so much.
Well, good afternoon, Mustafa. First of all, tell me about your initiative. How did you start it?
Okay, in 2014, Ban Ki-moon, the Secretary of the United Nations, picked 500 people to be the Global Youth Ambassadors of the world. Well, Dr. Nagla Fathi Lisi, a doctor, an Egyptian doctor, was picked to be the Global Youth Ambassador of Egypt. The aim of this initiative is to make these ambassadors work in global movements in the local, in their countries, to help the higher cause.
Yes.
Okay.
Can you tell us more about your activities here in Egypt?
Okay. Here in Egypt, we work on three aspects: women, children, and education, and youth. In women, we participate in mainly health awareness about breast cancer, and we work
female genital mutilation.
Yeah, and things like that. We work in some kinds of activities to remove the stigma against girls and things like that. We have a project called She Rides, which kind of provokes girls to ride bikes around the country and things like that. That's about women. In children, we enhance children education in slum areas and things like that. We participate in projects in educational development for children. And in youth, we work on leadership. Leadership in education, courses for soft skills and social skills, things like that, to prepare us, the youth, to deal with the old, the new world.
When did you join the team?
Last year.
Tell me more about your personal role in it.
My what?
Your role in the team?
Yeah, well, I joined the team last year. I was a new member, then I joined the fundraising team. I work as an organizer in our events. I organized about 5 events so far around the world. One of them was Women's Day, International Women's Day, in the Thessalonic village, and World Health Day in Cairo University, She Rides, it was all around Egypt, and our upcoming events, the World Volunteer Day.
Yes, if you can tell us more about your upcoming event and the preparations of your team to this big event.
Okay, this one is a great one. It's actually the first event of its kind, maybe in the whole world. It's called International Volunteer Day. It will be in upcoming next Thursday. It will be in the Higher Council of Culture in Doki Square. Well, the whole idea is about us, the volunteer, all the Egyptians working in the volunteering field, whoever they are and whichever organizations they work for, we will gather in one place to celebrate our achievements. We are the volunteers of Egypt. We do lots of work, and we kind of want to appreciate our work and send a strong message to the world that here in Egypt they are great. There are great people who do lots of acts. So the event will be some kind of fair for all the NGOs, all the student activities that work in Egypt. Until now, more than 40 organizations will attend this, will participate in this event. They will talk about their activities and their achievements. There will also be talks from public figures and speakers, and workshops for the youth, for enhancing such skills, how to prepare a CV, how to find international opportunities, and things like that.
Now, do you feel that taking part in community service changed you as a person?
Yeah, of course, it changed a lot inside me. Well, I started working in volunteer activities like 3 years ago. I was so young, I didn't know anything about the world. Well, I started discovering that it was like living in a bubble and all burst, and I saw a whole new world around me. I got a chance to meet lots and lots of great people who inspired me. One of them is Dr. Nagla, the Global Youth Ambassador. I got to work in many fields that I couldn't dream of being in. I got lots of experience, and it's still changing my life till now.
So what were the major challenges that faced you as soon as you entered this new world?
Okay, the biggest challenge is the time. You know, I'm a medical student, and you know, medicine is
a
very, very...
Needs a lot of study.
Yeah, lots of study. So time management was like, helped me. It was
so
very hard.
So did you graduate or not yet?
No, I'm still in fifth year.
Oh, so still need two more years.
Still need two more years.
And what are your plans for the future?
Well, of course, I'm studying medicine, so I guess I'm going to be a doctor. I like surgery, but I also want to have to continue my work as a volunteer, and you know, I have big dreams about this, making some kind of organizations or things like that. I want to have like a side career or something, not only be a doctor.
Now, for volunteering, do you feel that volunteering is popular in Egypt, or do we need to work more on volunteer?
Well, of course we need to work more, but volunteers in Egypt are more than we think, but we need more. Mm. That's how we put it. There are lots of volunteer guys there, and they are they are super active, super intelligent, and they do lots of great stuff that are not well aware or appreciated, but they are there. We need to include volunteering acts in like schools and for children to know the volunteering life from early childhood.
Well, what did you personally, Mustafa, gain from being a volunteer?
Well, personally, I guess my biggest gain is getting to meet new people. Well, in GIAT, we don't work as, you know, the classic team stuff where there is a leader and their head and task. No, we are like a family. We go to parties together, we celebrate each other's birthday, we help each other out in our personal matters. Yeah. Being just in a meeting in the team is the best thing that ever happened.
Now, which is the event that you're really proud of?
Okay, I guess the International Volunteering Day that's coming, we'll be really proud of, because it's the first kind of, it's the first event like this in the whole world. It never happened in the history of the world that more than 40 international organizations gathered in a single place to celebrate the International Volunteering Day and send a strong message to the world that there are great volunteers in the world and they are Egyptians. It never happened before, and I'm very proud that we will be the first ones to do this. Yeah.
Did you organize any events representing Egypt abroad?
No, I never got the chance to represent it abroad, but Dr. Nagla, she represents Egypt in the international fairs and competitions. Our reports of our events and videos from our events gets to be represented abroad. We signed petitions to be discussed in the United Nations Commission. We get lots of international accreditations. That's our main vision.
Hopefully one day you're going to be going to the United Nations.
Yeah, hopefully. Hopefully. I guess, what's holding me back is my studying and my exams. I don't get very much chance to travel yet.
Now, when volunteering, do you sometimes feel that there are obstacles, especially when you're talking about something like, for instance, FGM, or trying to talk about certain types of awareness for women? Do you feel that there is a barrier that the conservative of the society is actually affecting your message?
Yeah, exactly. But we're still fighting. We believe that breaking the stigma doesn't come just like that. We have to fight for it. We have to go Of course, you go in an awareness campaigns about FGM, of course you will get rejected. Of course people are going to say, what the hell are you saying? Go away, or things like that. But we have to keep fighting for it. That's how we break the stigma. There are difficulties, yeah, but we are fighting.
Yes, as we're wrapping it up, thank you so much for being with us, Mustafa Ibrahim, a member of the Global Youth Ambassadors team. Thank you so much for being with us on Mile Cruise, and we hope that one day your dream is going to come true and graduate and represent Egypt in the international arena. Thank you so much for being with
us. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
And now it's time to look into a report about the preparations for the African Film Festival. And from Luxor, and now more in the following report.